At 6, no more missing DNA. The state's new plan to make sure all felons are listed in the DNA data bank. The state of Wisconsin is creating a special task force to track down felons who should be in the state's DNA database. Good evening, I'm Shelby Croft.
And I'm Terry Sater. That's one of the solutions to the missing DNA problem discovered following the arrest of Milwaukee suspected serial killer Walter Ellis. Ellis's DNA should have been in that data bank, but was not.
New at 6, 12 News' Nick Bohr reports from Madison on the state's new plan to fill in the blanks.
For the first time since the DNA snafu was uncovered, the leaders of the state agencies responsible for collecting and analyzing it met here at the state capitol, and both say they're on the right track towards fixing it. Even before the state capitol opened for business, Corrections Secretary Rick Ramish arrived for a closed-door meeting with the Attorney General, 3 days after a terse exchange of letters over the DNA mix-up and how to best fix the process.
Politics should never get in the way of public safety, and I think that we're going to move this thing forward now and get it solved.
To make sure future DNA samples are accurately recorded, the Department of Corrections will be hand-delivering them to the crime lab under the Department of Justice, which will then notify the Department of Corrections that it's been added to the DNA databank.
It's our goal collectively as a group to look forward in solving the problem going forward, not necessarily to be talking about, past ills. It's my understanding that he has done everything he can to move forward. I commend him for that. We're going to continue to help him in any way we can.
The state is also addressing the estimated 12,000 felons for which there's no DNA on record. Governor Jim Doyle today announced 3,000 of them still on probation or parole will be ordered in to local jails to give DNA. For the estimated 4,000 felons no longer under state supervision, a special task force headed by a former Madison assistant police chief will track them down.
The model that worked very well was we found retired police detectives who didn't mind making a little extra income, and that's what we've done very effectively on the sex offender registry. And they know how to track people down. They know how to use databases. They know how to work in the law enforcement system.
We're going to do whatever it needs to be done to take care of this problem once and for all.
Secretary Ramish says he believes by the time this process is worked out, Wisconsin will become a national leader in collecting, storing, and recording DNA. At the state capitol, Nick Bohr, WISN 12 News.
The task force is expected to begin its work next week.